I suppose he was the first archbishop to hold a vivisection license, or at least the first archbishop since the Inquisition. He experimented on animals and himself to try and find a cure for wounds that wouldn't heal. It was at Cambridge, as the university fired itself up again following World War II lockdown. He was also the first archbishop to produce a all-in-one prayer book, the first archbishop since Thomas Cranmer. Unlike Cranmer, he wasn't burned at the stake, although with a very tetchy general synod it was a close-run thing. He felt it was ludicrous to believe in a God who reserved a parking space for yours truly, or a God who torched York Minster just because he was a bit miffed with David Jenkins. Without him and the 1993 Act of Synod which he created, I think today we'd either have two Churches of England or no Church of England. Because way back then, the ordination of women was the Church's Brexit, and he fixed it. He was an old Etonian patrician, with a death stare and a silence which would fry your brain. He played a very straight bat, except that once in 1985 he rigged the appointment of the Bishop of Portsmouth in order to enable Desmond Tutu to become Bishop of Johannesburg, and with that high profile, take on apartheid and win. Mrs. Thatcher, who was very pro-apartheid, was distinctly not amused and blocked him from becoming Archbishop of Canterbury. Oh, his first publisher was Mills and Boone. The title of that book was Religion and Science, so hardly a bodice ripper. His name, John Habgood, Archbishop of York, 1983 to 1985. Goodness me. 12 years an archbishop. I'm David Wilborn. I was his chaplain, and earlier this year, my biography of him, Just John, was published. I'll be coming to a virtual St. Albans Cathedral to talk about John Wednesday, the 30th of September, 7:30 p.m. Do join me, because it'll be such fun. And I promise not a single death stare. And also, no animal whatsoever was harmed for the production of this video.